just describe the votes that have taken place and what your thinking was with the removal of the emergency clause.
The votes that have taken place. So today we considered HB1, which is commonly referred to as the feed bill, which funds the legislature, funds for staff and for us to be up here. I proposed an amendment to that bill that provides that the money allocated from the last feed bill that has been not spent, that was for the attorneys to continue litigating the redistricting maps, that we not spend that money on additional appeals, wasting more taxpayer money, and instead provide that that money. My suggestion was through an amendment to HB2, that money be spent on disability, developmental disability waivers.
Okay. And the reception on the floor?
Well, party line vote. One of our guys was gone, and one of the Democrats was gone. So, it's clear to me that the Democrats' choice is to continue to waste taxpayer money on frivolous litigation.
More than that, I think it deviates from history. In history, when a plaintiff brings a redistricting lawsuit, they have to fund their lawyer's costs. And then if they prevail in that lawsuit, then the court issues reimbursement orders to allow them to recover their costs. In this case, the legislature is going to appeal, but not on their own dime, on the taxpayer's dime. And so we were just trying to say, look, if you're going to appeal, you can do that, but you're going to have to go get some private money to do it. Don't use general fund dollars paid for by taxpaying families and communities.
Right, and there are multiple parties to this lawsuit, as Matt. We have a lot of private litigants, Representative Maestas being one, Representative Egolf being another, and they've hired nothing but the best attorneys. So if they want to appeal, that's certainly their prerogative. All we're saying is, the taxpayers shouldn't foot the bill.
That's right.
So by attaching it to the feed bill, that obviously created some consternation on the floor. Where does that sit now?
Well, I think it's over. The vote's, the vote's taken. But, it was the only place we could attach it. It was the only bill that was coming along that's germane. So it was our only chance to do that. And, again, the majority's decision was to, waste more money on lawsuits.
How much money are we talking about?
To this point, we're still waiting to get some of the attorneys and experts, Brian Sandroff's invoices. But to this point, we've already spent roughly around $1 million of taxpayer money to basically sue ourselves. And so there's about $500,000 left that, again, I propose to dedicate to developmental disability waivers.
And this is on top of the $50,000 a day we spent up here for the special session, where none of this was hammered out because the other side refused to compromise. They wouldn't even include us in discussions on what those maps might look like.
Talk to me about the character of this session, because everyone has new districts now, at least if the current maps hold.
Right.
Of course, the speakership is in question. Certainly by next session, if not during this one. What's it like out there on the floor?
It's I think the governor's State of the States set a great tone, where we need to get stuff done. I think we're all a little frustrated, particularly in the minority, that we don't have any say. It's the speaker and the committee chairs have all the power. So we have these great bills, in my view, many great bills that are on the governor's agenda that, if we, if the committee chairs and the speaker wants to bury them, they can. So, I think we want to get stuff done, but will they allow us to?
It's also going to be an interesting dynamic as we start to get controversial pieces of legislation, perhaps out of committee and to the House floor. Members that have traditionally towed the party line are going to have to look very closely at what the people in their districts want to happen. For far too long, legislators that we've been opposed to, frankly, have voted one way when their constituents at home wanted them to vote another way. Well, now, competitive districts, according to the judge's ruling, and an informed electorate, things could change.